fight of the night then. First fight in ONE Championship history in Macau. Beautiful part of the world, very exciting town, very exciting action tonight, and we've got off to an exciting start as Kritsada leaps in.
Growing.
See Kongsira Chai immediately gets in nice and tight with that clinch, but Joshua spins him around. Now he's got him up against the cage right now. Nice belly-to-belly suplex there to take him to the mount. Beautiful transition there on the cage.
Remember, Joshua has an unbeaten record to defend. Training up there in altitude in Baguio means he's gonna be good for cardio. 3 5-minute rounds, this one scheduled to go.
That headlock takedown he's attempting right there by Kongsiri Chai. Again, Pacio uses the control to drive him down, but almost like a sacrifice throw, and Kongsiri Chai ends up on top.
Very busy, big sense of urgency from these two early on. More knees to the head from Kongsiri Chai. As he holds Joshua's head down, that head becomes a bit of an open target in that position. Shook himself free.
Pop himself out, and Pacio looks very explosive. A lot of his escapes.
Kongsiri's
so dangerous in that clinch. He's got those suplexes and those takedowns that come out of nowhere.
Despite being a wrestler, Kongsiri Chai likes that knee to the body that's very reminiscent of a Muay Thai fighter.
He doesn't like getting into the clinch much. He doesn't go into the Muay Thai clinch. He's primarily got that over-under grip, and he loves the belly-to-belly suplex, or possibly even that headlock takedown he likes.
See how strong Joshua's legs are as he presses his opponent up against the cage wall. Could be a tiring business, that.
Action!
Pacio shoots him for the legs. Now he's got a single leg. Good defense by Kongsiri Chai. Nice wide base, spins him around. That elbow just thudded off the top of Pacio's head. Those elbows are so dangerous.
Halfway mark in the opening round. Swung those punches in, Joshua, without really looking where they were going. Wanted to keep his head down and his face out of trouble.
Drops his head and hopes for the best as he swings for the fences there. See, I gotta wonder why, you know, Pacio is attempting to clinch and maintain these things. Now he's got double unders now, where he's got both hands underneath Kongsiri Chai. But you can see how Kongsiri Chai has kind of laced his arms over Pacio so that he can probably, that's a suplex possible position right there. He spins him off of the cage. There that is, nice little trip to end up in side control.
So remember, Kongsiri Chai is a wrestler. That's his place.
Chai's like off his back. He's able to get almost back into full guard, where he's got both legs wrapped around Pacio almost. He might try to step over the leg there and get into half guard. Yep, gets over one leg. Now he's gonna try to slide that right leg of his through that knee and attempt to pass into side control. So you can see him pushing down the knee up. He ends up in the mount instead. It's a bad spot for Pongsiri Chai to be in.
So what can he do with 50 seconds left in the opening round? Plenty of time to do some damage.
He's a little bit high up on the back. He's trying to flatten him out. You can see Pacio. Now he's going to rain down some punches. Uh-oh, one hand's under the neck. There's a rear naked choke.
Yuji Shibata's looking closely at this, watching for the tap. Is that arm underneath the chin and around the throat? 30 seconds left to find out.
Kongsiri Chai's got to try to peel that arm off.
It's over. Yuji stopped it. He must have seen a tap that I couldn't see from the screen here in front of me, and nor from the other side of the cage where I am.
Yeah, Steve, I think he went out. That choke was deep, and Kongsiri Chai, there was no quitting him at all. Pacio put him to sleep.
I think that could well have been the situation. Joshua Pacio. improves his unbeaten record to 8-0. Mark Sangio, head of Team Lakai, very proud of his young man there. Remember, he's only 20 years old. Still unbeaten, 8 big wins in his career. Now let's see what we can see from some of these replays. This was about, oh, that right hand from him. Took that punch well. But it was once they got down and Pongsiri Mitsatit managed to turn around. There he is, giving him his back. And then it was the choke underneath the chin that did the damage.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Yuji Shimano calls a hold to this battle at 4:37 of round number one. Here, winner by submission, by a rear naked choke, Joshua Pacio!
Young Filipino, so young and already with such a big and impressive record.
Choke! The Philippines' Joshua Pacio.
Pacio says he wants to test the stand-up of the Sanda champion. He wants to utilize that push kick and his big 1-2 combination to really see what the defense like is of Lan Mingqiang.
Lan Mingqiang wants to keep the contest on the feet. Pacio will test the striking, look for the takedown, and hope to sub him with a rear naked or a guillotine. Lan Mingqiang did say, I'll knock him out in one round. It was a bold prediction from the Chinese martial artist who lands an inside thigh kick. Pacio has got to have his defenses on the money. So too is counter-striking here, Mitch.
He's trying to time it, catches the low kick, transitions into a nice body clinch. Double under is easy, able to slide into side control. It's a bad spot for Lan Mingqiang to be in. He's got to create a little bit of movement. He throws his leg up, crosses it over his own leg, and that kind of prevents Joshua Pacio from sliding the knee onto his belly.
Let's see how Lan Mingqiang handles the ground. Off his back here, the Chinese cuts the hip into Pacio, drops the elbows to the ear of the Chinese martial artist. Here come the knees to the rib cage.
This is what we thought was going to be the difference maker in this match, is the grappling of Joshua Pacio. Typically with Sanda artists, you see them throw somebody and then they back off because that was a point scored. They don't typically stay on the ground. But with Joshua Pacio, he has a well-rounded ground game. Now he's on top, dropping a little bit of the elbows, trying to soften him up. Ooh, he steps over in the mouth. This is a bad spot for Lan Mingqiang.
Great fight for the legs, and he did so easily there, Joshua Pacio. What a ground display so far from Pacio.
Lan Mingqiang's got to let go of that body lock he's got. He's got to create a little bit of space. You can see the hips of Joshua Pacio are pressing down. That's kind of neutralizing Lan Mingqiang from moving away.
Round and pound here, still from the mount position from Joshua Pacio. Postures up now. There's the elbow. Turns the knuckles in off the right hand. Dominance here from the young Filipino.
Good hip pressure. He's got his legs sprawled out. He's pressing down on his hips. See that hip pressure? Lan Mingqiang can't go anywhere. Now he's looking for possibly an arm triangle, but he's got to give up, mount, and go over to the other side.
Is it going to happen for Joshua Pacio? Can he find the finish on Lan Mingqiang?
It's a tough spot to finish. He's got to get over onto the side. The arm triangle, he chooses to let it go.
Mingqiang survives, and Pacio, it's all one-way traffic, still in the full mount. How does Lan Mingqiang get out of this match?
He's got to push off the hips and start bumping and elevate the hips of Joshua Pacio, and then slide his hips out. He's got a bad spot. He's choosing to defend the strikes. In that spot, you know you're going to get hit.
Triangle. Cries a
transitions into mount, drops a little bit of ground and pound, but then gets the back and finishes with the rear naked choke.
Emphatic victory for Joshua Pacio. Brandon Vera Pacio is a young man going places in a hurry.
In a hurry. This kid is amazing. He puts everything together so well. He uses ground control to cause damage to make his opponent turn his back.
Joshua Pacio, the most emphatic of victories, the very way he predicted it, the talent at that age to do that is amazing. Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Jeff Andres, property president of City of Dreams, Manila. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 1 second in the first round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Joshua Pacio!
A massive ovation for Joshua Pacio. Another winner's medal around Pacio's young neck. And around the neck is where he went. On a hapless Lung Ming Chun, just as he predicted. Submission, rear naked choke.
Go!
Turning into the elite athlete he is today. Let's see if DeLegas can get his hands off here. And indeed, that's how he opened up the second stanza.
Just barely gives him a buzz cut on that right kick again. But DeLegas counters nicely with that left hook to the body.
Counter right hook there from DeLegas. The southpaw once again controlling center cage. Pacio on the outside, turning back kick. Uchidogeri from Joshua Pacio. DeLegas edges forward. Does have that one punch. Precision. So to Pacio. Joshua Pacio back in the winner's circle.
That was superb. Out of nowhere, Joshua Pacio closes the show. Beautifully done. Turns the lights out. Look at his misses. Spinning back fist right on the button. Goes low with the leg kick. Follows it around. The guard is down.
It's just when we said DeLegas had one punch KO power, just as we said it, Joshua Pacio, one punch KO, good night Roy DeLegas, a spinning back fist of the highest order.
Pacio does it all. Not only can he grind on you and finish you with the ground and pound and submissions, but now we're seeing the knockout power of Joshua the Passion Pacio.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chen, has put a stop to this contest after 38 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Joshua Pacio!
Listen to the ovation here in Manila. Tears of joy for Joshua Pacio. Back in the winner's circle. Tonight.
And it's one brought to you by City of Dreams, Manila. More power to your play.
Two very accomplished strikers. We might see the Go Daddy knockout of the night here, Michael.
And indeed, both men predict the finishes. Pacio says triangle submission. Pongsiri Mitsatit says KO overhand right. Now Mitsatit packing that right hand is ungodly. The inside leg of Pacio. It's a tip. Looks like he's cleaned up a little for this match.
Yeah, he spent a lot of time out there at Tiger Muay Thai getting ready for this matchup. And he says that he incorporated a little bit more strength and conditioning than usual into his program. We got the Muay Thai style of Mitsatit going against that Filipino wushu style. Joshua Pacio, contrast the style, should make it.
Incredible first.
great finds, soften him up.
This place will be jam-packed in about 20 minutes, half an hour's time. And they are watching Joshua Pacio in control, full mount on Pongsiri Mitsatit in the opening round. Already one win on the board tonight for Team Philippines. Courtesy of that lead hand of Pacio. Everything on the lead thigh and shin, calf area of Pacio. Pacio, the leg kicks for the champion. There's another one. Fourth round of five. Jab to Pacio. Again, Mitch gets in quick and scores, gets out.
Pacio, we expected to see, those fast blitzes, bop, bop, in and out. So we're just kind of getting hypnotized by it. Now he's starting to come forward.
Mitch, if the match was stuck right now, who would you have ahead?
And after the first round with the knockdown, beautiful kick there from Saruta. Landed on Saruta. That big first round knockdown, but now I'm starting to see in the second, third round, Pacio starting to inch forward. I think he's more aggressive. I think his striking superiority is there.
It's a headlight count from Pacio. After you were nice enough to from Saruta, under 3 minutes remains. Penultimate round of action here. Certainly seeing some heavier artillery being launched now by both of these world champions.
In the first match, we did not see Saruta do a kickboxing match with Joshua Pacio. He was going for takedowns. He was mixing things up. He was inside the clinch, wearing on Pacio. Now, all he's doing now is just striking with him in the last couple rounds. But to answer your question, if the match was stopped right now, I might give a slight edge to the Team Lakai athlete. Oh,
Mr. Kemp Chang has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 43 seconds in the fourth round for your winner by way of knockout! And new ONE Strawweight World Champion, Joshua Pacio!
Once again, a world champion. Team Lakai, once again, has a world title belt in its possession.